Okay, baik. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Hari ini kita akan belajar tentang cara nak buat the Fleming's right and the left hand rule. And kita akan tengok situasi mana kita akan guna the Fleming's right hand rule, situasi mana kita gunakan the Fleming's left hand rule. Simple je, okay? So, untuk the Fleming's right hand rule ataupun left hand rule, kita sebenarnya guna di dalam subtopic 4.3 kita, iaitu apa? Force on a moving charge particle in a uniform magnetic. So, kalau kita ada charge particle, tak kisahlah yang positif atau yang negatif, it's moving inside a magnetic field. Okay? So, when it's moving inside a magnetic field with a velocity of V, dia akan rasa magnetic force oleh magnetic field tu. Okay? And always remember, kita punya Fleming's right hand rule ni must be perpendicular to each other. So, dalam ni, the direction of the velocity and magnetic field should be determined by you lah. Usually velocity dia bagi, tapi kalau dia tak bagi magnetic field, the magnetic field can be determined from the right hand curl yang kita buat previous video lah. Okay, so you need to determine the direction of force macam mana by using the Fleming's right hand rule ataupun left lah. So apa perbezaannya? When can I use the right hand, when can I use the left hand? Okay, so use the Fleming's right hand rule when we're dealing with positive charge. So you see positive charge here and the positive charge here, we'll be using the Fleming's right hand rule. We will be using the Fleming's left hand rule when we are dealing with the negative charge. Okay, so starting untuk kita punya force on a moving charge particle, equation kita adalah F equal to Q V cross B, in which case we can expand this from the vector form kepada dia punya magnitude form, iaitu QVB sin theta. Okay, so we will be crossing. Okay, our definition adalah apa? Our thumb will be our force. Okay, our index finger ni, index kita macam pistol ni, will be kita punya velocity, and our middle finger will be our magnetic field. So force, velocity, magnetic field. Okay, as you can see, all three components are perpendicular with each other. So to use the Fleming's right hand rule ataupun left hand rule, okay, rupa dia macam ni, macam gaya gangster sikit lah. Okay, the component will always be perpendicular with each other. So as you can see, katakan saya nak cari, for example 1, I want to find the magnetic force experienced by this positive charge. So remember, positive charge kita akan guna Fleming's right hand rule. So velocity is your punya index moving towards the right. Then I have my magnetic field yang ke bawah. So as you can see, my thumb is pointing inwards. Okay, so the magnetic force is into the pitch. So F is into the pitch. Okay, the pitch. And also a side note, kena ingat, when you use the Fleming's right hand rule ataupun left hand rule, all three of your fingers akan ambil komponen dalam Cartesian. Meaning that kita punya, sini adalah contohnya X, sini adalah kita punya X, ini adalah kita punya Z, ini adalah kita punya Y. But depending on how you use it lah. Okay, so now what if dia tak bagi direction of B? Okay, dia bagi current. For this part, you kena combine what you learn inside the previous video, iaitu kita punya right hand rule. So right hand rule macam mana? Direction of current naik atas as kita punya thumb. So kita punya curl is into the pitch. So here, our magnetic field is into the pitch. Okay, then bila you dapat magnetic field yang into the pitch and velocity here, to find the magnetic force, you use back the Fleming's right hand rule. So velocity moving towards the right hand side, and I punya magnetic field, which is my middle finger, is into the pitch. So as you can see, my force is moving upwards. Okay, so I have my magnetic force upwards. Okay, so now for the second situation where I'm going to use the Fleming's left hand rule. Left hand rule is used for the negative charge. Okay, so when you jumpa negative charge, you guna you punya Fleming's left hand rule. Dia punya definition pun sama. Okay, definition of the Fleming's left hand rule pun sama. You punya thumb adalah you punya force, you punya index adalah you punya velocity, and you punya middle finger adalah you punya magnetic field. So you can see, for the first example, I have my velocity which is into the page, so index saya ke dalam, and also I have my magnetic field yang ke atas. So magnetic field ke atas, my V is into the page, so my force is towards the left hand side. Okay, so my force here is towards the left hand side. Okay, again, kalau kita jumpa a negative charge yang bentuk dia macam ini, okay, we have the magnetic field which is into the page, okay, and velocity ke bawah. So again, my index finger is moving downwards, and my magnetic field is into the page, which is my middle finger. So my thumb shows the direction of the force, which is towards the left. Okay, So both of them here sama je lah direction dia. Okay, so the force is towards the left hand side. So remember the main thing, okay, kita guna Fleming's right hand rule for positive charge, kita use Fleming's left hand rule for the negative charge. Okay, harap membantu. And please remember this this definition ah, sebab untuk kita punya next case, iaitu kita punya current moving inside a conductor, kita akan carry semua forward, iaitu thumb kita force, middle finger adalah magnetic field, tapi kita punya index akan tukar pada current. But that is inside the next sub topic. Okay. Okay, baik. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Hari ini kita akan tunjuk on Fleming's right hand rule version kedua. Okay, kita guna version kedua ni di dalam subtopik 4.4 dan 4.5. 4.4 apa? Force on a current carrying conductor in a uniform magnetic field. So maksudnya kalau saya ada wire, okay, wire sini, wire yang dalam wire ni ada current I. Kalau saya bubuhkan wire yang ada current I di sini di dalam uniform magnetic field, dia akan rasa force. Kiranya boleh either to the left or to the right, depending lah on macam mana orientation magnetic field and current dia. Okay, so we determine the direction of force ni menggunakan kita punya Fleming's right hand rule. So sebenarnya banyak, ada yang kata guna Fleming's left hand rule, ada yang kata guna right hand palm rule. So if you're watching this video, saya akan tunjukkan macam mana kita guna right hand rule. Dan it's a bit simpler, sebab if you learn already the right hand rule, the first version, di mana you punya thumb adalah you punya force, you punya middle finger adalah you punya magnetic field, you punya index adalah you punya velocity dalam 4.3. Dalam 4.4 ni, dalam subtopik 4.4, sama saja you punya thumb dan you punya middle finger, tapi you punya index akan tukar kepada current I. Okay, current. Okay, so kalau di dalam 4.3 kita buat middle index kita sebagai velocity, dalam ni index kita adalah sebagai kita punya current. So I have two example here on how we determine the force experienced by our current carrying conductor. Okay, so how do we do it? Okay, so kita ada current yang bergerak atas. So my index finger here, my index finger is my current. So the current naik atas and my middle finger shows the direction of magnetic field. So X is into the page. So masuk, so my magnetic force experienced by the wire caused by the magnetic field adalah towards the left hand side. Okay, so this is F lah. So you have tadi apa, current using your index naik atas, magnetic field into the page, so my thumb points towards the left hand side. As you can see for the second example pula, kita ada current I yang turun bawah, my magnetic field which is my middle finger yang masuk, so my direction of the force is towards the right hand side. So this is the force. Okay, so kita guna ni dalam subtopik 4.4, iaitu force experienced by this current carrying conductor in a uniform magnetic field. Apakah equation dia? The equation is F sama dengan I L cross B. So if you remember the cross product waktu kita buat dalam kita punya 4.3 pun adalah it's a sine quantity. So F sama dengan B I L sin theta. So the magnetic force is equal to the magnetic field experienced by the current carrying conductor. I is the current carried by our conductor, L is the length of the conductor, and sin theta. The theta is the angle between B and I, not the L. Tapi kenapa dia gunakan L di sini? Okay, so the L is used for the cross product here because the L, the length of the wire carries the current. Okay, so the current here is carried inside the length of wire. So sebenarnya walaupun the L cross B, tapi the angle theta here is between I and B, not the length L. So please be careful. Okay, so the second part of kita punya Fleming's right hand rule is actually used dalam kita punya 4.5, iaitu force between two parallel current carrying conductor. So now what happens, kali ni saya tak bubuh my wire dalam uniform magnetic field. Kali ni my wire ada dua tapi tak ada magnetic field. So macam mana kita nak buat Fleming's right hand rule kalau tak ada magnetic field? Okay, you use back the equation. Kalau saya nak cari force on our first current, F pertama akan sama dengan BIL, but the magnetic field is caused by the second wire. Okay, always remember this. Okay, so dalam kita punya 4.5, kalau kita punya nak cari the magnetic force of wire pertama, okay, magnetic force of wire pertama, the magnetic field is caused by the second wire. How do we do the magnetic field on wire 2, on 2 wire 1? Kita use the right hand rule. Okay, so saya nak cari magnetic force on wire 1 disebabkan magnetic field wire 2. So wire 2 magnetic field, our thumb naik atas, it is curl out of the page. So sini adalah dot dot dot. Okay, so dot ni out of the page cause B2, magnetic field caused by the second wire. Okay, so please remember the B for the current in two parallel current conductor, the magnetic field is caused by the other wire. So sekarang ni bila you ada magnetic field yang points upwards, you guna Fleming's right hand rule, current naik atas, magnetic field pointing upwards, okay, up of the pitch, so the magnetic force here is inwards, F1. Similarly, kalau saya nak cari force F2, dia akan equal to B1, the magnetic field caused by the first wire equal, okay, B1 I2 L1. Okay, walaupun the wire itself produces the magnetic field, but there is no force experienced by the first wire onto its magnetic field by itself. The magnetic field is always caused by the other wire. Force experienced by the first wire onto its own magnetic field is not felt. Okay, nanti kalau korang tengok, actually there's no distance between the magnetic field. Okay, so itu nantilah saya tunjuk in later class. Tapi for kita nak cari magnetic force 2 pula, okay, the magnetic field B1, so daripada B1 current naik atas, so it is curled into the page. Okay, into the page here. So ini adalah X. Okay, ini adalah B1. So now you can use the Fleming's right hand rule. Current naik atas, okay, magnetic field is into the page, the magnetic force is towards the left hand side. So this is F2. Always remember in 4.5, the direction pula, okay, is caused by the second wire. The magnetic field is caused by the other wire. Okay, the magnetic field by itself is kiranya you cannot have a magnetic force kita punya wire by itself. It must be caused by the other wire. Okay, so hope this helps. I'll see you guys again in the next video.